Hello students, I welcome you all to this session. I am Vishali Kikan and today in this session I will be talking about the clean rooms and the clean room protocols in the IC production. So first of all, what is clean room? Why it is required? In the previous video I have talked about the yield. So whenever we have particles present during the production of an IC, it will be killing the yield. It will be degrading the yield. Whenever yield is less, our profits are less. So we require the clean room so that our yield will be high. So IC fabrication must be done in a clean room and we require artificial environments with low particle count so that our fabrication process will be having the highest and highest possible yield. So now the clean rooms were first used for the surgery room to avoid the bacteria contamination. It was adopted in the semiconductor industry in the 1950s and smaller devices need higher grade clean rooms. We have different grades of clean room. I will be talking about it soon, that what kind of clean rooms we have, how we have divided various types of clean rooms. So if I have lesser and lesser number of particles, more and more expensive will be the fabrication of the clean room. So now if I am talking about class 10 type of clean room, so it is defined as less than 10 particles which are having the diameter larger than 0.5 micrometer per cubic foot. So class 1 is defined as less than 1 such particles per cubic foot. 0.18 mm device require higher than the class 1 grade clean room. Okay, so this is how you can understand if I am going downward in the class, the number of particles will be less. Okay, so these are the various classes. This is my class 1 lakh. So here you can see I have more number of particles now. The particle size is also decreasing. So here the number of particles are also high and the particle size are also high in the class 1 lakh. Then class 10,000. You can see the number of particles decreased as well as the particle size decreased in microns. Then class 1000, then class 100, class 10, class 1. And then class M1. So okay, we have all of these classes and now I hope you understood which class is the best class for our clean rooms and which kind of classes, clean room classes we require for a particular fabrication. So this figure represents the effect of particles on the mask. So masks are required for the fabrication of the diffusion layer. So whenever we have the particles on the mask, so here you can see the particles are present here. So here the particle is present here as well as here. So now you can see if I am having a particle here, it will be forming a stump on the photoresist layer. So okay, here we have an extra photoresist layer. If I have to remove the silicon dioxide from this part, it will not be removed. So here it will be causing some problems and the defects will be caused, the yield will be degraded. So this is how we have the effect of particles on the mask. Again, I can have the film in between the portion where the film should not be there. So I can have two cases. Here the film should not be there. Here the film should, here it is present but it should not be there. Here it is present and here also it should not be there, but because of this particle it came. So now because of this the doping profile will be changed, and because of the change in the doping profile I will be having different electronic properties and which we don't require, and at last we will be having the defects and the lesser yield. So you can see we have the particle contamination effect on the doping as well. So you can see here if I have the particle present here, it affects the implanted junction as well. So here we don't have any implantation because the particles blocked all of the ion beams which are coming upon it. So here we have the partially implanted junction and this will be a defect and this will be again lowering down the yield. So I hope now you understood how the particles are playing an effective role towards the yield and towards the defects. So the particles will be increasing the defects, and at last they will be decreasing the yield, and at last they will be decreasing the profit. So now coming to the clean room structures. So this is the structure of the clean room, and here you can see we have the makeup air. So the makeup air will be going inside. We have very high purified filtered air here in the processing area. And here we are using the processing tools, and from here I will be returning air with the help of various pumps and exhaust as etc to the outside world. Okay, and we will be requiring equipment area of, like, let's suppose class 1000. We can have various classes here, and with the help of various instruments we will be controlling the particle size as well as the particle width and the number of particles also in this area. So this is how we have the clean room structure. Now the gowning area. The gowning area is the area in the front of the clean room. So now you can see here, this is the opening to the clean room. Just before the clean room we have the gowning area. So in this area we have the, first of all, gown racks. So in this racks we will be having some gowns, we have some storage, we have wash or clean stations. This is the entrance, and here we have shelf of gloves here and shoe covers. We have to wear all of them, gloves, hair cover and shoe covers. So now we have some disposal bins here. Again we have shelf of gloves here. So this is how we have the gowning area, and from this gowning area we will be moving towards the clean room. So now coming to the IC fabrication process module. So here we have the full process. In the full process, first of all we will be having the deposition of thin film. So in the deposition of thin film we will be having the thin film of oxide layer, and upon which we have the photolithography. With the photolithography I can perform the etching and the PR stripping, and then we can have the diffusion or the ion implantation. So both of these processes requires the process called etching, which means removing of the dioxide layer on a particular area so that we can diffuse or we can implant thus impurity into our substrate. So this is how we have the fabrication floor. So these are the sliding doors through. So here you can see these are the sliding doors. This is the gowning area. From the gowning area you can enter here, and this is the service area. So now here from the corridors you can go to the various equipment areas, okay, where you can do the processes, and here we have the process bays also. So these are various process bays, and you can go to the equipment area with the various sliding doors, and you can use any process bays. So I hope now you understood each and everything about the clean room, and these are the references. I hope if you want to study in detail about all of these topics you can go to these books, and these are really amazing books. So I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe the channel and share this video with your friends as well. So if you have any kind of doubt you can contact me, or you can put the doubt in the comment. Thank you so much.